Welcome to this phase four practice video. Slightly different format here because my camera broke. No camera right now. So I'm doing this live to you stream. And what we're going to do here is we're going to practice. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This is the root practice. This is the most important practice. It is in a world of do your own thing, be unconventional, etc., like that, which is, you know, it's the culture we're in. It's what we're used to. It's what I'm used to, and all of that. I tend to throw out convention in a lot of ways, but in this instance, we're going to have one convention. We're going to do that, and this is the one convention, and that is this root assertion. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Okay. Now, I have been using this and using this and using this more and more and more. And this morning, I use it to a tremendous extent. And I began to notice something quite amazing, is that in my mind, I would begin to drift off into some sort of naughty situation, and then I'd go back to it and I'd dispel it like this. And I began to see that the knots, the entanglements, are all in our mind, actually, and that everything is only a mental projection. There's nothing external to the mind. Everything is mind. Everything is mind. And what mind is doing is it's projecting and believing that projections leave their source. So believing that all of this is external to the mind, and therefore the mind does not have complete control over it, which is a complete lie. It's an utter pretension, total pretension. Okay, so I began to see this, working with, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This is the fundamental convention that I have decided upon, that yes, this is what works. This is the medicine for the mental headache that we have, which is this delusional belief that projection results in separation. It does not. It does not separate cause and effect. Now, mind throws another little trick in there, which is called time, and it believes that time is somehow in play with this projection about what does it leave the mind or not leave the mind, or does it come back to the mind. There's something called time, which is a variable in all this, and this is the biggest lie of all, and was the most insidious lie of all. There is no variable in this. There is no equation. Projections do not leave their source, period. There isn't any variable whatsoever. But mind claims that time is a variable, and somehow it's in play. It's in play somehow, and we have to wait. You know, wait, not yet, wait. Instead of, no, right now I am not a body. Right now I am free. Right now I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. The mind says, no, that might be true, but not now. See, time is in play. There's no such thing as time that's in play. It's not in the equation at all. There is no equation. So we are affirming, and I would say even more, we are asserting. We are asserting the truth to mind. This is the medicine. This is the aspirin for the mental headache we have. And we have all these knots in our mind, so to speak. We need to undo those knots. Our mind is believing that we're a body. We are not a body. The mind is not a body. Okay. We are mind. We are spirit. We are mind. We are not a body. There is no such thing as any body, anything external to the mind. And since it's not external to the mind, it's just an imaginary image that we're projecting, the body. It's not a real body as the way we think about it at all. The mind, it's completely, it's just mental stuff, as it were. Mental thought, mental imagining. So, in working with this basic practice, this practice comes from Jesus Christ directly in saying, if there is one, the way he put it is that if you are wondering, is there one practice that I can recommend to you that is the most effective, the most direct, the most quick, the very best medicine to take, is there one thing that you can recommend to me? This is how he phrases it. Because he knows that people are saying, well, look, there's all these exercises, so much to do, but is there just one thing I can focus on and it will be successful? That's easier, right? And Jesus says, yes, that is true. It's easier that way. And yes, there is one practice that you can do, which he says will absolutely work and will be tremendously successful for you and will absolutely undo the knots in your mind. If you do it, you see, if you do it. And he says, do it as consistently and as often as you can all during the day. This is the way. And what he says is, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And Jesus promises us, if we do this consistently, keep at it, this will seep in, this will heal your mind, this will undo the knots in your mind, the insanity in your mind. It will treat it right now. The treatment for the mind is right now, always right now, and the mind keeps trying to trick us by using time, trying to bargain with time. You must completely reject such a bargain. Time is not in the equation whatsoever. And so insist, assert it. This is an assertion to the mind. Okay, the attitude is important. You're asserting it. You're saying to the mind needs to be healed here. The mind is quote-unquote sick. It's pretending to be very sick, thinking that it can externalize anything at all. Something can be separate from cause. It cannot. So we assert to the mind. We say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And you will find, as you do this, obstacles will come up. And somehow you will find yourself suddenly your mind wandering off, and you can see how it's getting into a knot, tying itself in knots, and just go right back to the practice. Don't try to undo the knots. The practice does that itself. Do not analyze. Do not struggle. Don't say, no, wait a minute, I see all this here, and now how can I figure out the mind is going this way and that one is twisting it like that? Don't do that. This is time, you see. You don't need any time to be well. The mind doesn't need any time to be well at all. Okay. Because nothing has ever externalized. Nothing needs to come back into the mind. Nothing needs any process to somehow get right, to be inclusive in the mind. It's already this way. So I am not a body. I am not a body. Meaning right now, I am already not a body. I am already free. I am already still spirit, exactly as God created me. So the assertion is, it's right now. See, this is the attitude. It's right now. This is true. I am not a body. Right now, this is true. I am free. Right now, this is true. I am still spirit. Right now, this is true. Exactly as God created me. Right now, this is true. See, no funny business with time whatsoever. You lay down the law with the mind, and you assert to the mind that this is true. Say, mind, this is what's true right now. Okay, and there's no such thing as time. Okay, there's no principle of time and play whatsoever. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, Jesus' advice to us is to practice this and practice it and continue to use it more and more and more and more until you can use it continuously all during the day. And this is his advice in response to what he knows to be our question. Is like, is there some way that can just get the job done simple and just quick and succeed, and that's it? And he says, yes, there is. Yes, there absolutely is. This is very similar to advice given out by other teachers in other times, where they said, just say this and that's it. Just focus on this all day, as much as you can. Don't stop. Focus in on it. And it's a similar variation of just, it can be like just, I am. I am. I mean, right now, I am. This has been used in, but our way of, what we're going to use is, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And you will find it becomes very interesting as you begin to see that these resistances, these strange resistances of physicality, trying to tell you you're a body, try to pull you down. And you say, whoa, wait a minute. I'm the one who's in charge here. I'm telling you, I'm saying mind, I am not a body. I'm speaking for the mind. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And continue to hammer that home, ceaselessly hammering that home. Do not get into any discussions whatsoever. Do not get into any analysis whatsoever. You are simply healing the mind. This is medicine. You're delivering an IV, spiritual IV treatment to your sick mind. Because the mind that believes that it can be a body is very sick indeed. So the treatment is to state the truth, and this reminds body, oh yeah, it reminds mind, not body, it reminds mind, oh yeah, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, having test piloted this, I have some hindsight, which is very helpful in order to help others. Hindsight is extremely helpful, which is why these great teachers are so helpful to us, because they have the hindsight and they know the mind perfectly. They know our mind way better than we know it right now. Okay, because they have the hindsight and they know exactly what our problem is and exactly what to do to heal this problem. So we benefit from their hindsight. And then those who test it out and trust and have faith and are willing to do this, we begin to see, wow, you know, I can see it is undoing this knot. And it is this. Wow, this is really on track. This is really on track. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, it's a habit. It's a habit. The more we do it, the better we get at it. The better we get at it, the easier it is. The easier it is, the more effective it is. The more effective it is, the more we're motivated to apply it. So, this, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Lay down the law. Assert the truth. Assert the truth to yourself, to your mind. Assert the truth. Be assertive. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And the ego keeps telling us, well, you can't do that. You know, time won't let you. Well, yes, we can keep doing it. You know, we just keep thinking that somehow time needs to be accounted for somehow, and then that stops us. But when we realize time has nothing to do with anything, it doesn't really, it's something that mind has made up. All right? Truth doesn't need time to be true. All truth is true right now. All truth is true right now. And the fact is, I am not a body. See, that is true right now. The fact is, I am free. That is true right now. The fact is, I am still spirit. That is true right now. Exactly as God created me, that is true right now. So we are only stating what is true right now. Okay, and what is true is always true. What is true is true right now, and it's always true. Okay, and lies are always lies. Lies never become true. See, the ego believes that time, if you give lies enough time, they will become true. If we repeat, if we assert lies long enough, the ego, the mind telling us it will become true. And this is a lie. This is a lie. Lies never become true. Okay, lies never become true. So we don't, it's not like lies have become partially true with all this time that we've been asserting lies, and therefore somehow we have to undo time with these assertions. We don't have to undo time. Time has never had any effectiveness whatsoever. Zero. So we don't need to undo zero, do we? Okay, we don't need to undo zero. This is why simply saying this, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. We assert this right now, plain and simple, direct. That's it. Okay. We do not have to account for any contingencies that we think time has brought up, because it hasn't brought up any. Nothing has ever happened within time, with time. Nothing has happened. Absolutely nothing has happened. Truth remains still perfectly true. There's been no erosion. There's been no momentum built up. Time has not built up any momentum at all. That is a pretense as well. There's no momentum built up at all. So this medicine works right now. Okay, we don't have to hold back saying, oh, wait a minute. I'm going to say it once, and then I'm going to wait a couple days, and then I got to wait for time to adjust to this. Time hasn't done anything. Nothing has happened in time. And since nothing has happened in time, there really isn't any time. It's a cause without any effects is not a cause at all. And time has not had any effects at all. None. We're just pretending that we're being affected. And therefore, saying that time is a cause. You know, if we pretend, oh, this is happening to me, this is happening to me, then we can say, well, since this is happening to me, there must be a cause, right? And so we say, well, time must be real, then it's cause. But nothing is happening to us. Nothing is happening to us. We're only pretending that it's happening to us, but we're doing it to ourselves. The mind is twisting itself in knots. Nothing is causing the mind to knot up. Time is not causing the mind to go in knots. The mind is twisting itself in knots and then claiming that there's some cause of it, because mind said, well, I wouldn't twist myself in knots like this. Yes, it would. Yes, it would. If it's trying to trick God, which is what the mind is trying to do. Mind is trying to be greater than God by making God lesser than mind, you see. And by twisting itself in knots and then claiming that there's some cause called time and that God needs to help out with time is a way to try to trick God and entrap God in time or in imagination, and then we can believe that we're then greater than God. So mind is twisting itself in knots. There is no cause causing this. There's no other cause except for mind doing this. So there isn't any time that we need to defeat. There's nothing that needs to be defeated. We merely assert the truth right now, and that is, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Our spirit mind. Mind is often thought of the active. We talk about spirit in an active way of tying itself in knots. We tend to use the term mind, but it's synonymous. Synonymous, the same, talking about the same, spirit, mind. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So I would say, for those who say, you know what, I truly want to have a healed mind right now. I don't want to wait around. Then this is the way. This is the way. This is the way. It's to keep this continuously going all day. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. To keep it going, keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. This is, I have faith that this will be effective. I'm testing it out on myself. I'm aware of progress. I'm aware of results. Subtle, okay, but definitely there. And again, we're talking about advice from one who knows our mind perfectly, way better than we know it. So if Dr. Jesus says, here, do this, this is the medicine you need to do, and you're going to get well, guaranteed, then, of course, if we're smart, we're going to take that medicine. And who doesn't want to be smart, especially now in the way that the world is going? Some think it's going in a great direction. Others think it's going in a terrible direction, actually. And so, if you believe, you know what? See, I don't really want to have anything to do with the future of this, you know, this trend, the way things are trending. I really don't want to have anything to do with it, to be perfectly honest. It's just more mental self-deception. In fact, trying to increase the self-deception. Then we say, you know what? It's time to heal the mind. And I use the word time there, but let's say let us have healed mind right now. Let us not keep this stupid delay going, which is basically just indulging the notion that not all the knots in the mind are self-inflicted. Okay, this is what we, when we indulge delay, what we're saying is, well, okay, mind, I think that 90% of what's going on is self-inflicted pretense, but there's probably, you know, some in there that's not, and so we need for you to be able to work on that, you know, and so you make a deal like that. This is what causes failure. It is 100%. Everything the mind we are experiencing is comes from the mind. It is self-inflicted 100%. There is not one iota of any of this self-inflictedness that is other than the mind. Not one iota comes from quote-unquote time. Not the tiniest bit ever. So there are no deals to make with mind whatsoever. There are absolutely no deals to make. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Assert it, you know, just as best you can. I know maybe it's not easy. You might just, I'm not, don't slouch, you know. Don't slouch, don't get goofy. No, assert it. Just keep asserting it. Doesn't matter what the mind says. The mind says, ah, you're crazy. What do you mean? What about the stuff that's not self-inflicted? No such thing. There isn't any. There isn't any. I am not a body. See, the mind thinks, well, we need the body to deal with the stuff that isn't, that is not self-inflicted. We need the body to deal with what's being caused by this external source. You know, there's something being caused by this external. No, there's nothing at all being caused by any external source. A cause with zero effects is not a cause at all. It doesn't exist. It's just a mental pretense. So time is a mental pretense designed to actually ultimately trick God so we can be greater than God. See, we can't be more than God because God is all there is. So what we're trying to do is make God lesser somehow so that then we can say, okay, we're prime creator. Look, God's lesser than us. So the only way we can do is we try to pull God down by claiming there's some external, there's some source, some cause external to the mind that God created. Some cause external to God that God has to deal with. And so we're tying ourselves in knots, the mind, and then claiming, hey, God, you know, some external source caused this. And God says, no, you did it. Mind says, no, I wouldn't be a body, you know, I wouldn't have, I've been turned into a body. God says, no, that's just a mental knot in your mind. You're just believing it. Says, no, I wouldn't believe that. No way. It's been inflicted upon me. You see, all this stuff's being inflicted upon me, God, by some external source. This is a lie. This is a pretense. This is mind pretending all this to try and trick God into thinking that it's true. Now, you know, liars who want to convince you of something. Let's say somebody has this pepper, hot pepper, and it's really, really hot. And they want someone else to eat this hot pepper, right? Because they want to laugh and feel superior to them. Because as this poor person is like just, you know, just going through a near-death experience almost and just, on fire, you know, and they want to see them suffer, and so they can feel superior. So they're thinking, okay, he says, I know this pepper's hot, because I've eaten it, and it's like incredibly hot, and they say, but if they know that it's hot, they're not going to eat it. So what the liar says is, hey, I got this great pepper, it's a really great flavor, it's got some heat to it, you know, and it's, you got to try this out. And they say, well, how hot is it? And they say, oh, it's about you know, kind of mildish, medium, very nice. And you get a little, it gets nice heat to it, and it's got flavor and everything. And here you go, try it out. And the other person says, well, I don't know, it looks kind of hot, you know. And they say, no, it's not hot. Don't worry, not a problem. And then they say, well, and then the liar says, hey, okay, I got to convince this. They say, I've got to convince them to eat this pepper. And they really want to, so they say, okay, I have another one right here. It's the same. Let's say it's the same. He says, look, I'll show you. It's not hot. That's good. They say, oh man, that's got great flavor. Really fruity flavor, earthy tones to it. Nice, even heat is spreading. You know, it's just a really mellow heat. It's great. Wow, it's wonderful. But meanwhile, they're just on fire, you know, they're just absolutely burning up, tears coming down their cheeks and just suffering horribly. And yet they're saying, yeah, see, it's not hot at all. Here, try one. It's not hot. Well, they say, well, why are you so quiet and you can't hardly talk and you're choking? I don't know. I just, it's weird. I don't know why. There's something, maybe an allergy. I don't know what is going on. They're lying, okay? They're lying. So a liar pretends that what they're lying that is not a problem. Say, look, not a problem, God. They say, hey, God, time's not a problem. It's not a problem being a body. It's not a, time's not so bad. We got to try it out, God, you know, something like that. We're trying. So we are suffering terribly in our attempt to trick God. By tying ourselves in these horrible knots and then claiming, no, God, this doesn't come from me at all. Doesn't come from me at all. And so we're the ones who are suffering in trying to trick God. Our mind is, we feel suffering, we feel this terrible suffering. And yet we're trying to say, God, no, God, it's not bad at all. There's no trouble at all. Meanwhile, we're terrified, we're fearful, we're depressed, we're confused, we're just mentally ill, we're just, you know, suffering so terrible. But it's all a pretense. We're all pretending that there's some external cause of this, where there isn't. And God knows very well we're just pretending. There's no external cause. So God is not fooled at all. So we might as well stop this whole charade. We might as well stop this charade and saying, yeah, God, I've just been tying myself in knots. There's no external cause. Now, because there is no external cause to any of this, it's completely curable. Completely curable by simply the mind simply accepting what it actually is, and that it is, I am not a body. Okay, the mind is saying this. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This cures the mind. This cures the mind of its affliction. The affliction is in the mind. It is not resting in anything external to the mind whatsoever. therefore, the entire cure is mind cure. The entire cure is mind cure. Cures everything. All affliction that the mind is suffering from is totally cured by mind cure, curing the mind, totally, without any exception whatsoever. So, we only need to say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This is all we need to say. That's it. And the mind, of course, will say, yeah, that's great. I feel some success with that. But what about the other stuff that it's not helping out with? No, it's curing everything. It's curing everything. There is no external cause of anything that is taking place in the mind. There is no such thing as any external cause. So, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, when this can be said continuously during the day, and I'm practicing this, I'm trying more and more to do this, you'll see, you'll be watching like a golf tournament and you suddenly remember, oh, or basketball, or whatever, or driving, or watching the internet, looking at something, and you remember, oh yeah, I gotta keep saying this. And you can even say it during perfunctory prayers, other kind of prayers, any kind of talk, whatever you're doing, you can keep saying, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And when the mind says, okay, now wait a minute. No, wait a minute. Because the mind, what the mind is saying hey, great, I think I'm kind of getting this. The sick mind will say, oh, okay, I don't quite have this. And the mind says, well, I need to try to use this now against the external cause that's inflicting, causing some of these afflictions. So how do I use it and be effective there? Because it doesn't seem to be so effective there. And maybe I need to think about it a little bit and give it a little time to work there before we keep going on with this, because it's not, this is the trick. The mind will tell you, well, it's not being effective against this external cause, or maybe it takes some time to be, there is no external cause of mental affliction. This is a trick, the mind. Don't pay any attention to the mind when it says that. You just keep saying, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. You're laying down the law to the mind. You are the medicine that the mind needs. Be the medicine that the mind needs. It needs this medicine. It absolutely needs this medicine. And the mind is sick. It is crazy. It is, but it's really caught up in its own pretense. It's believed its own marketing. And in fact, the mind believes that the only way to trick God is to completely believe in its own marketing, in its own lies, completely believe. So the mind is so caught up in believing its own lies, you see, that you cannot trust the mind when it begins to wander. But there is an aspect to us, we call it the Holy Spirit, the Holy Mind, the aspect to us, that spiritual will, that can act like a medicine to the mind. And we have to be that medicine for the mind. We are the medicine for the mind. We say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now the mind will keep throwing trick after trick after trick at you. Doesn't matter. Don't explain to the mind, so to speak. That when the mind is tricky, don't explain to the sick mind. It can't understand anything. It's sick. It's crazy. It's insane. It's believing external causes. You cannot reason with such a mind. So you simply be the medicine for that mind. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And the mind will say, yeah, well, there's some minds then that are not gotten free of external influence, but there's other minds, they're not free of external influences. So how do you treat them? There's no such thing as some minds and other minds. There's only one mind. There's only one mind. There's no such situation as some minds and other minds. Doesn't exist. It's a lie. There's only one mind, one mind. One mind of truth that is all true, nothing external to that mind. So there are no minds that are free of external influences, and then there are other minds that are not free of external influences. That does not exist. So just keep asserting to the mind, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And again, you will get into some interesting, you will see some monk tricks of the mind, and but don't catalog them. Don't say, okay, now what do I call this trick? How, let me figure out exactly what. No, don't do any of that at all. We're here as medicine, not as catalogers or analyzers, okay? We're not analyzing. We simply, I'm forgetting to practice, give the medicine to the mind. Oh, the mind is sick. I need to give it its medicine. Oh, more IV. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, as long as we're giving this medicine to the mind, we are doing exactly what Jesus recommends that we do. And so we are on track, okay? We are on track. As long as we are applying this medicine and apply it and keep applying it as much as possible and just do just that, not something else, just that, okay, we are on track. We are giving the medicine to the mind. We are healing the mind. And that's it. We don't need to discuss it with the mind. We don't need to talk about, well, how on track are we? And get, no, just keep giving the medicine. The mind will try to drag us into all sorts of discussions. No. You know, if there's a sick patient there and they need this IV, then you just make sure that IV, it keeps getting the IV, and you don't turn it off and to discuss something. They say, hey, can you turn that IV off for a moment? Because I really got something really important I want to discuss. No, we're not discussing anything. We're just giving you the medicine that you need. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Okay, we're just taping this outside and there's all sorts of commotions and stuff, but I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And it's fascinating to use this because your mind will wander and you'll suddenly realize your mind is like way wandering off in crazy land. And you say, hey, wait a minute. Whoa, just hold on. He's like, whoa, how did that happen? Why is my mind there, you know? Okay. And instead of trying to answer, well, how did I get there? Now, what kind of train of thought? You don't need to believe in time led the train of, is the train of thought there. That's the only reason. Trying to trick God, belief in time, that's it. Just give the cure. I am not a body. Just, oh, the mind is still sick? Okay, great. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Just like that. You just notice, oh, the mind's still sick. Okay, great. Treatment time then. Treatment, medicine time. See, the mind needs a lot of medicine, actually. Spiritual medicine in the form of this assertion. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, we don't have to understand how this medicine works. It works, okay? It gradually undoes the knots. There's something going on there. I don't know what it is. Oh well. I can't pause this, is the only thing. I don't know what's going on. I cannot pause it. It's direct, it's live, there's no pause button. And that's the benefit of having a camera. I can pause it when there's disturbances, I'm interrupted or something like that. I can't do that here. But let your practice be uninterrupted then. When there are disturbances in your life, just say, great, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So it is super important to get this practice down and just absolutely get better and better and better and better at it, because there are additional assertions that we can make that have even more oomph to them, but they're so intense you can't do it all the time, all day, really. You can't really do it. For instance, the last video I recorded, which was the practice, yes, I already know that this depression is exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this fatigue is already exactly the way I want it to be. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this world is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this anxiety is already exactly the way I want it to be. Yes, I already know that these technical problems are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that that all is exactly the way I really want it to be. This, it did 2 hours of that, 2 hours and 14 minutes. I had to cut off the end of the video because it only gives, YouTube gives us 2 hours and 10 minutes for edited videos. It was so powerful that I felt physically collapsed sometime after that. I felt I couldn't stay awake, and my body was just like, my mind was so stunned by the impact of this practice that my body was just kind of like a rag doll, sort of, you know. I could hardly move, I could hardly do anything. I just lay there in bed just like, wow. I said, wow. But after about three hours, I bounced back. But to do that sort of intensity all day, it's too much. So what the secret is of success is to use this, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This is like an aspirin or something, like ibuprofen or something for a headache. It is gentler, it gently and powerfully works. And then you can intersperse it with these other I am already practicing as if, which is super potent. But you can overdo that. You can overdo it. And what happens when you overdo it is you just feel like you've lost, your body just feels tired. I mean, you feel it's a different kind of tired. It's just like, oh, you're like shocked by the success of it. It's very, the success is just, wow. I'm just blown away by the success. This is just, oh my gosh, I'm tired. So it's a positive strain. And there's no problem. You rest a little bit, absolutely rest, but don't try doing it all day. Do not try to do it all day. You can overdo it. So do it little bursts during the day. Okay, like a 5 minute burst, or you know, 5 or 10 minute bursts, and then just stop and go back to I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me, and keep that going all day. At least that's your goal. Keep it going all day, and then intersperse that with numerous little wind sprints, little bursts of I am already. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that this situation is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Okay, this is a very powerful practice like that. Just saying it a few times, you can feel you can feel something like, wow, this is just impacting, very impactful. Don't overdo it. Don't overdo it. Now, there are times, and maybe in the evening you'll watch a video of I Am Already, and you'll do it for several hours, and you know, then you'll go to sleep and rest, and in the morning you'll feel better. You get some rest from it. So you, but during the day, all day, it's not advisable to do this I Am Already, that intensity, continuously, okay? You can overdo it. You can overdo it. Now, I took my blood pressure after that. I was feeling kind of woozy and just this overall general malaise of my body. I'm just weak. I feel just weak. And the blood pressure was okay. It was perfect. So it was just a psychological, you know, reaction to, wow, I'm getting better. I'm getting so much better. You know, it's just shocking. Okay, so we have the tools we need. We have the tools that we need. To succeed, we have the tools that we need to succeed. Right now, we actually have the tools that will get the job done. It is merely a matter of now doing it. Okay, it's merely a matter of doing it. It's like we have the lumber, we got the saws, we got the framing guns, you know, we got everything we need, and we can build a house, so to speak. It's just a matter of doing it. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Don't explain to the mind how it works, why it's working, how fast it's working. The mind, don't get into any discussion with the mind at all, okay? I am not a body. I am free. We're not discussing, we're asserting. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. We're asserting because we know the mind has been pretending to be a body, okay? Pretending to not be free. Being bound, pretending to be bound by time, some external cause, pretending to not be spirit anymore, pretending to not be what God created as. It's all pretense. It's all pretense. So we're simply waking ourselves up from that pretense, as it were, waking ourselves up. So we have plenty of time on this video. The sun just dipped behind a cloud there, and it's going to boost the gain a little bit. That's too much. Okay, we can do that. All right. Yeah, a little chilly today, a little breezy in one here. We're so spoiled in California. If it's not a perfect day, we say, wow, it's a little, not quite the same as yesterday, which was perfect. So, only problem is, of course, no rain, no water. Minor details, like that. It's like the mind saying, yeah, everything's fine, except there's no peace of mind. A little minor detail there. The mind says, don't worry, time will take care of that. See, the mind is always saying, don't worry, you don't have to do these practices. Time will take care of this. That's a lie. How can time take care of this when there's no such thing as time? You see, this is the trick of the mind, isn't it? The mind says, no, these problems I have, they're getting better. Time will heal all. Time heals all wounds, you know. Well, there's one little problem with that mind. There is no such thing as time. So if there's no such thing as time, how can time heal the wounds? And the mind says, well, I'm inventing time. No, you're not. You're just twisting yourself in knots and then claiming that's coming from some external source. And you say, God, I wouldn't do this to myself. It's some terrible malevolent, it's, you know, source, external source. And I've got to convince that external source to stop twisting me into knots. So I need some time for that, God. I need time to convince time. You see, time takes time. It doesn't do it all at once, God, you see. So it's going to take a long time I need to first convince time, and then it's going to take a long time to untwist all these knots. Time will do it gradually, God. It takes a lot of time. And, of course, God will say, there is no time. So how can you say that time needs time to undo what time has done when there isn't any time? Let me see how to boost this up. Oh, there we go. Okay, I gotta look now. See, this is funny, isn't it? Now here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. Wonderful. Wonderful. This gives us a lot of time to catch our breath. Here comes the sun. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Okay, now that was a little goofy. That doo-doo-doo-doo, referring to what? Here comes the sun, a song. So what we do in practice is a few things, a few protocol. It's just, it's very simple. We don't get goofy, okay, in our practicing. We don't get goofy. We don't bring music or song into it. We don't get goofy. We stay sober. We stay sober and serious. We can laugh at how crazy the mind is, sure, but we don't go goofy. So, and we don't slouch. We don't slouch. We keep our overall body language and mind, everything is spiritually assertive. Spiritually assertive. We're spiritual marines. We don't back off what we're saying. We don't back off what we're saying. No. Okay. We are adamant that, you know, we're treating a severe illness, so to speak, mental illness the mind has. And we're very serious about this. Okay. It's not a game. It's not a game. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. You see, mind believing that it needs time to undo the problems that time supposedly caused, that can go on forever, because there isn't any time. So as long as mind is waiting for time to heal mind, mind isn't doing anything. It's just wandering, aimlessly wandering around. Nothing's happening. Nothing is happening. And since nothing's happening, and mind thinks that this is what it has to do, it could just keep wandering around and wandering around and wandering around and wandering around. Nothing's still going to happen. It can wander around forever and a day, and nothing's going to happen as far as time, because there isn't any such thing as time. So ultimately, spirit gets tired of this, and it's so sick. The mind is so sick. It keeps tying itself in more and more knots to prove that there is time, so that then it can believe that time can then undo the knots that it already has. It keeps doubling down on the knots. For example, it says, I got this terrible knot that time caused. Okay, time, I got to pray to you, I got to worship you, I've got to ask you to please undo this knot, time. As if there's this external source, external God, external source that's caused this. And it doesn't work, it doesn't work. And then the mind says, wow, I need to believe in time more. You know, maybe time thinks I'm not believing in it enough. That's why it's not effective. So what it does, it ties itself in even worse knots, so that it can claim even more. Look at this horrible knot. I couldn't possibly have done this to myself. I would never do that. So it must be coming from time. So therefore, time must exist. Therefore, my prayers to time must be effective. It must be hearing my prayers. And I know that I can get time to help undo these knots for me. You see, that doesn't work either. Doubles down again. So just waiting is really what happens, is you keep doubling, ultimately you double down. You double down. This is why I say that this civilization, this culture, the way things are going now, is it's doubling down. It's very bad. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So, if we don't cure the mind, give the mind the medicine it needs, the mind will continue to double down. It will continue to twist itself in more and more terrible knots. As you see, people in this world are getting very weird. Okay, very weird indeed. And they're doing all sorts of bizarre stuff with the body, trying to do more and more twisty, distorting stuff, tying itself in more and more knots. You can tell these people are all knotted up. You know, you can just feel the mind, why the mind's really knotted up terribly. And of course, they think they're winning. They're winning, because they say, this just proves there is time. And as soon as I prove that there's time, I'll be able to access time and then get time to heal my problems. That'll never happen. Will never happen. And this is the trouble that they are most certainly in. And it's not a nice trouble at all. It's misery because you keep doubling down and you keep thinking, this has to work. This has to work. This has to work. Okay, this'll have to work. More pain. This'll work. Even more pain, more sickness, more trouble. Okay, this got to work. And this is how the mind keeps thinking. This has got to work. This has got to work. This has got to prove that time exists. This has got to prove that time exists. And as soon as I prove that time exists, I'll be able to access it and get the help I need to undo this stuff that time has caused. There is no time. Time has never caused anything. So how can we appeal to what doesn't exist to undo the knots that we ourselves have caused? Effects don't leave their cause. So it's the mind that has to let go of the knots. And what we find out, as soon as we accept it's the mind, there is no time involved. The more we accept this, the more the knots just spontaneously just dissolve. Right? Because no, we're not waiting for them, for something external to do something. And what I've seen is that it's quite possible to simply, the whole thing just resolves like, easy. We just relax. The whole situation just relaxes. The knots just gently all relax like flower petals just floating to the ground. So our beautiful flower petals, and it's just gone. All gone. The knots are gone. The delusion is gone. So we're gentle with it. You say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And so these are like flower petals dropping off like fruit trees, one at a time. Now we can come along and shake the tree, and a lot of petals come down. And that's great. Like, wow. If you've seen that, like a strong breeze comes up, cherry blossom time, you're in like cherry blossom orchard or place, and so, there's all these beautiful pink blossoms, and a strong breeze comes up or something, and you see like thousands and hundreds of thousands all over, just beautiful pink blossoms gently fluttering down to the ground. You're just like, oh my gosh, very stunning. It's so beautiful, you're just like stunned by it. And this is what I mean by the intense exercises we do, by I already know that this situation is already exactly the way I really want it to be. That's like shaking the tree and a lot of petals come down, you know. But it's so beautiful that we're stunned by it. Whereas, and when we're stunned by it, we can still then have just, you know, petals just gradually, you know, more easily, just a few here, a few there, just kind of a more steady, minimal stream of petals coming down. And that's not so stunningly beautiful to us. It's still very beautiful, but not as stunningly beautiful. This is a good analogy to use. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Okay. This is like giving a gentle IV to the cherry tree, so it'll gradually drop its blossoms like this. And then we can put in some more powerful spiritual medicine where the cherry tree suddenly, you know, releases, you know, a burst of petals. And then we just say, oh, wow, beautiful. That's great. That's great. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Exactly. Nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. So, it's irreversible. Now that we hear this this explanation about time and how the mind is trying to get help from time, thinking time caused its problems, you realize that that's completely futile. Once you realize it's completely futile, you better have an exercise like this, right? So, and you won't see this clearly until you're doing the exercise. Once you know you can do the exercise, once you prove it to yourself, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Once you know you can do this, once you're confident you can do this, then you will see what I've been talking about in this video about mind and time, it will clarify for you. And you just say, oh my gosh, yeah, wow. Doubling down, and just you see the insanity of what mind is doing. But you won't see it really clearly until you are have this practice, you're able to do this practice, because at that point you need to do practice, right? Because you realize that's the only way. There isn't any other way. So if you saw this clearly without being proficient in practice, you would definitely freak out and you would go start tying yourself in even worse knots, okay? The saving grace is that you can't see it really clearly. You cannot really see it clearly, not for more than an instant. You might be able to glimpse it just like that, you know, just get a glimpse of it, yeah, and then it goes away. But for me now, I'm able to just look at it and see it in an extended way, and it's become overall clear. It's overall clearing, like the clouds are clearing. But it doesn't scare me, because I say, no, I'm not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I know I have a practice that works. So the fact that there is no time to help us undo the knots is okay, because I know how to undo them. And I have the medicine, I'm applying it, and I know it's going to work. So it doesn't scare me that much. It's a little shocking, of course. You see this, just like, wow. Holy cow, good thing I have this practice. Good thing I have this practice. So do not be disturbed if intellectually you cannot see this clearly. This, don't struggle with that. It will never come intellectually clear until you actually are proficient in practicing. And then when you are, it won't be a struggle. You'll just see it. You just say, oh, yeah, of course, this is the problem. I see it now. Like that. Because you feel safe. I can do this practice. It's not a problem. So this is why practicing is all important. You'll never get it spinning your wheels intellectually. You'll never get it that way. You know the answer's there, right? This is the frustration. You know the answer's there. You've glimpsed it. But you will never get to it intellectually. Having it. You'll never get to it intellectually. You have to get to it by practicing, because you cannot sustain this clarity intellectually if you're not proficient in practicing. You will freak out, no question about it. It's kind of like you saying, oh my gosh, what I thought was the only cure there was for all my problems, now I realize that doesn't exist and I don't have any cure. You'll freak out, and you'll then go back and desperately trying to prove that there is time. Try to desperately prove there is time, because the fear, you're just in a state of extreme fear. So here, there is not that extreme fear. I'm saying, great, not a problem. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. That's all that we need to know. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So you can start out by saying it intermittently. You know, this, what these videos are trying to help you is to get, you know, get up to speed. Start getting up to speed. There's no other way. It's like riding a bicycle. You need to learn to ride the bicycle. You know, at first you're wobbly, and then you go a little better, and then you can kind of go slowly and carefully, and eventually you're up to speed. So it's like riding a bicycle, learning how to ride a bicycle. We all did. We're learning to walk. We all learned to walk, right? So it's like that. So I keep interspersing, you know, interspersed with a little bit of talk, and then I am not a body. I am not a body. Okay, I am not a body. Period. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. When we say, I am not a body, what do we mean? Meaning the mind. When I say I, we're speaking as the mind, as spirit. So we're saying, I, the mind, I am not a body. I am not a body. I am free. The mind is saying, I am free. The mind is saying that it, the mind, is free. There's nothing outside of the mind. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I hope this audio is coming through clear and not all on all these breaking up, which is, this is the flaw of this program that crept into it somehow, is the audio gets broken up and then people don't like listening to it, which if that's the case, I don't know what I'm going to do. We will see. I don't know why the camera just suddenly stopped working. God has something, but I can say, hey, yes, I already know that this camera not working is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So this is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Okay. No matter what happens, it's always exactly the way I really want it to be. This is a powerful, extraordinarily powerful practice. And then we go back to, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly how God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now you will find that at times you're just doing it just kind of automatically and not really think about it, but then try to pull back your mind and say, and really assert it, like, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. See if you can get a little punch of assertion in there, a little jab of assertion. I know we're afraid of the ego and thinking that somehow we're insulting time, and therefore time is not going to cure the ego's problems, and the ego's going to get very mad at us for insulting time, insulting its idol, the idol of time. So we kind of feebly jab, you know, I don't want to get the ego too mad, and say, no, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Assertion, assert, assert, assert. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, understandably, you see, you will be feeble at first, usually, and I don't want to rough up the ego too much. I don't want to get the ego too angry at me. I want the ego to think I'm just sort of playing around here, you know, and there'll be that attitude might be there a little bit, like, oh no, I'm just kind of, ego says, what are you doing? I'm just kind of goofing around and having fun, and you know, and just that's where we get goofy. So no, I'm just goofing around, ego. Not really serious here. And the ego says, I don't like the way you're doing. It's insulting to time. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Take that. Boom. Yeah. Start hitting the ego with some good jabs. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this moment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all moments are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all moments are already exactly the way I really want them to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, when I say don't slouch and don't get goofy, this is very important, because the ego is going to try and intimidate you into claiming that you're just like a little kid, just imagining, playing games and being goofy and silly. And the ego says, you're just joking, right? You're just being silly. And you go, oh, and you get goofy. Okay. So now I say, no, we're spiritual Marines. We don't back down. I said, I'm not being goofy at all. We're absolutely serious. I am not a body. I am free. I am spirit. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Don't argue with the ego about whether you're serious or not. Prove it by asserting, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So this is why I say, don't slouch. Don't get goofy. Don't go goofy. When we do, I'm starting to take it easy on the ego's idol of time, the ego's insane notion of time. No, we're not taking it easy on that. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So, for those of you who want to see, who like to see, you know, analyze, like to see what's wrong, you will see it. You will see it. Don't worry. You know, those who are very reason-based or really want to understand, you will see it. But you will only see it when you actually let practice be the predominant effort that you're making. Okay. Because then in seeing it, you will say, it's okay. You know, it's okay because I've got the means to cure it. Oh, it's okay. There's no time. No worries. I have the practice. I'm very proficient at it. I just keep doing this and it's going to work. So it's okay. This has to happen this way. You can spend a lifetime trying to, for instance, see what I just saw in this taping about how the mind is trying to use time and stall and delay and claim it needs time to cure what time has done. And seeing that also clearly, you can spend a lifetime of academic effort trying to see that, and you will never see it as clearly as I just saw it. You will never see it. And I can say this because that's what I've basically done. I mean, I've been working on this from the get-go of this life. And so you could say I've been working on it like for, you know, 50 plus years, actually, trying to figure it out. And yet just like a month and a half of practicing this practice, and I'm already seeing way more clearly than all of my 50 some odd years of effort. I started very young. I started from the get-go. I was focused on this. So, and I've never stopped. In a month and a half, let's say, of practice, let's say just 2 months, round it up, 2 months of practice, and I'm seeing way more clearly. Okay, so you will not be cheated from your understanding. Your understanding won't be cheated. Okay? It will not. You will get it. You'll get it better than you've ever imagined. You will just see, oh my gosh, I see it so clearly. There's no confusion at all. It's just crystal clear. I just see what's going on. Wow. But then you have to fall back on, hey, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So we have to reconvince the mind that it is the mind, you know, that it is exactly the way that God created it. It's still that way. Otherwise, the fear is going to arise because the mind is saying, wait a minute, there's no time, but I thought that time caused all these problems for me, and now that there's no time, how can I cure these problems? I didn't cause them, you know, and so I can't cure what I didn't cause, and, you know, and the mind starts getting real jittery. It starts getting very jittery, which is why you can't get this clarity without practicing. Cannot get it. You can get a glimpse, and then it's gone. Whereas this for me is not just a glimpse. I understand, I see it now. So I see this, I can reference it anytime I want to. It's obvious now. So I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Now I say this for those who are very intellectual, who are very smart, you know, a lot of reasoning. I'm saying, okay, you have to do the practicing, because I was been the same way. You cannot become a spiritual know-it-all without putting practice first. You cannot. And once you put practice first, then you realize why practice has to be first. There's no way around it. So don't spend your whole life trying to be a spiritual know-it-all and not practicing, because you will be very discouraged and bitter. And say, it doesn't work. You know, this is all a scam. Or you'll just, you know, be depressed. So I tried as hard as I could, and it still didn't work. You know, okay, so I'm explaining the reason of this now. When you see that there's never been any time at all, everything is self-inflicted, then that means time. There's no agency of time to undo anything at all, right? And if you don't have a means to undo the knots of the mind, then you think that you're just stuck with those knots forever. And you can't abide with that at all. So you will most definitely, well, what you'll do is you'll try to figure it out mentally, and that'll drive you crazy. It'll exhaust you. You say, well, how do I untangle all this? It's impossible to deal with it that way. And you will double down and try to knot yourself up so badly that you then believe in time, and thinking that that means that time, you just weren't worshiping it enough. And now that you're worshiping enough, time will come out of hiding and say, oh, okay. You know, as if time says, well, I didn't want to help you before because I didn't really think you really believed in me. But now that I see you really believe in me, I'm come out of hiding, and now here I am, and to help you and make you happy, and I'll undo all the problems, you know, that I caused you. And, you know, that's what you end up getting caught up in that inextricably. You know, it's inevitable that you'll get caught up in that. Inevitable. And then you go on what's called the dark path, the black path, and blah, blah, blah. You know, you just double down, keep doubling down, and get frantic, and you can become, the wheels can come off. They do come off and in various ways. So none of that is necessary. None of that is necessary. None of that is necessary. All you have to do is just a simple, fundamentally effective medicine. Give the medicine to the sick mind. That's all. Just feel like M&Ms. Here's another one. Here's another one. It's like a dog. You know, a dog is there, and you got these treats, and you know, the dog, ah, and like that, and you can sit there all day and toss treats to a dog, right? And the dog's never going to turn. Automatically, the dog is going to take that treat. he's not going to turn down. I've never seen a dog turn a treat down. So, just keep tossing. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And the mind can't help but, you know, take this in. It keeps taking it in. It can't not take it in. So, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Now, you don't see any of these top teachers historically bragging about how much they know and all this kind of stuff. They always say, hey, you got to practice. Practicing is the way. It says once you practice, you will see what you need to see. It all becomes clear to you. This is what they always emphasize, because they understand this problem, okay, this issue of thinking like, oh my gosh, how am I going to undo what time has done when time seems to have vanished? You know, it's gone. How can I undo this? I can't. I'm stuck. Oh, terrible, right? That way never works. So First, we give the RX, we give the medicine. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. First, we give that medicine. And as the mind starts to heal up, then the mind will be able to look and say, oh my gosh, yeah, I see what I was doing. I was tying myself in knots, trying to fool God and thinking that there was time when there never was. And okay, that's great. Oh, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. See, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, the egoic mind will say, okay, that's enough. You've dissolved a lot of time, and I don't want all time to be dissolved here. I might need a little help from time, so can you ease up? No, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. There isn't any time to get rid of. Time is not dissolving. That's not the situation. So we don't wait to heal the mind, because the mind says, well, wait a minute, time dissolving, and that's enough time dissolved. No, that's not what's happening. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And don't buy into the ego saying, oh, that's great. You're doing great. You know, and okay. I think time has had enough. There is no time. So that is completely false. We say it again. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, you can tell the difference between when you do the super intense, like, yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be, including my, yes, I already know that all my difficulties are already exactly the way that I really want them to be. All of my failure, yes, I already know that all of my failure is already exactly the way that I want it to be. When you do this type of practice, you can feel this deep sort of ache in your system, as if this deep, 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 powerful feeling that, and that you can feel, wow, eventually you get to say, wow, I need to take a little rest from that, pragmatically. You know, the physically, I feel, wow, that's a tremendous strain. That it's so successful. That's amazing. So then just go back to, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This is a much milder, smoother way, form. And you can keep doing that all day, actually. Now, maybe when you first start out, you might feel, oh, yeah, okay, I need to start. That's fine. If you feel physically like that you've tired out, you know, or you feel this wow is just, you need to just stop for a while, that's fine. But don't ever buy into any egoic explanation of that. Don't ever buy into that, because then it'll try to negotiate with you. Well, when do I start again? Well, let's ask time when you should start, you know, like that. It's not time that you start yet. It's asked time. You start. What happens is you get into your mind about doing the exercise instead of feeling how you feel how you actually feel. So stay in touch with how you actually feel. Stay in touch with called your feelings. We don't mean your emotions, okay? Your reactions, your emotions, your drama, or anything like that. We mean we just, how tired do you feel? How much strain do you feel? How worn out do you feel? This is what we mean. Get in touch with how you feel. How you feel. And if it's genuine, you feel, okay, this is really, okay, genuine. Then I say, okay, I'll take a nap, I'll rest, and a little later I'll bounce back, and you will bounce back. The mind is, when the mind is being healed like this, it does feel, it can get tired, you can feel tired, and then it bounces back, and you feel even more capable of doing it, even longer. So, to be able to do it all day like this, yeah, you build up to it, you build up to it. It's like I had to carry this real heavy lumber load, so many trips of super heavy lumber on my shoulders, and it just like broke my back and shoulder down. It was just, and after doing this for like three different times over a period of like maybe 10 days or so, I actually felt a lot stronger. I suddenly feel like, wow, I feel like I'm a lot stronger than before. You know, initially I felt tired, really tired, but somehow I bounced back from it. So it's like exercise. You can feel tired after exercise, physical exercise. And then a little later, maybe next day, you say, wow. Or a couple of days later, you'll feel, I'm feeling, you know, stronger than I used to feel. This is pretty cool. So stay in touch with how you feel realistically and monitor your own self, how you feel. Everyone has to do this. Nobody can tell you how you feel. You have to be able to monitor yourself, which is easy. You just don't get into your mind. Don't let the ego start trying to tell you what to do. You just, as soon as you feel the ego trying to tell you what to do, say, hey, this is a good time to say, hey, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, you may find that saying this first time, you kind of get it. Second time, not so sure. Third time, you can kind of lock into it after the third time, fourth time, and you start feeling more assertive, like you're really asserting it and feeling it and asserting it. So, yeah, that's what I experience. I am not a body. I am free. I am spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, if you don't quite feel assertive as you want to, don't stop and try to analyze why you're not feeling assertive. Just keep saying it through in normal speed. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am spirit, exactly as God created me. Just keep saying it through. Don't halt yourself and say, wait a minute, I'm not sure I'm getting it. Don't do that. Okay, that is not helpful. Say it through and keep saying it. And then after you keep saying it, you'll tune into it and say, oh, okay, now I feel a little more assertive. And sometimes maybe you won't feel that assertive, but it's still being effective. It's still being effective. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So what happens, what fourth phase is, we're in what's called fourth phase practice. And what fourth phase practice is the realization of the limitations of the intellect, of trying to understand there's an inherent limitation, there's an inherent problem there. It's, Jesus calls us this gap. There seems like you can't get past this gap. And I experienced this. I got to the point where there's nowhere else for me to go. I had to, there's a gap. I said, how do I get over this gap? I couldn't quite bridge the gap. No matter what I did, I couldn't bridge it. And then I came across Jesus' explanation saying, this is what happens. And you have to take what's like a leap of faith, and you have to practice the as if you're already on the other side, as if you've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. You have to get into practicing at that point. You can never satisfactorily resolve the situation through mere intellectual conceptualization. It's not possible. And so I took the leap of faith and started phase four practice. This is what phase four is, practice. And it's recognition that you can only go so far intellectually, and then you just spin your wheels. You just spin your wheels. You can't go any further. Can't go any further. You know, all you can do is try to impress more people about how smart you are, but your own progress is stalemated. It's stalled out. And I've seen this happen with so many people in the world. They stall out here, and what they do then is they go around trying to impress everybody about how spiritually smart they are, and they spend the rest of their life doing that. Okay, this is very common. Doesn't have to be that way. Just try two months of practicing. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And you will then convince yourself that this is the way, and then you realize, I got over that gap. Yeah, there was a gap, and I've passed the gap, and it's irreversibly successful. You're now irreversibly successful. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This, the medicine, undoes the knots of the mind that it's tried to twist itself into. But of course, it's all pretension, right? It's all pretension. No external cause to it whatsoever. So, those who have stalled out. Now, this is the area that a focus that I'm helping to bring here is being around those who have stalled out my whole life and seeing it, and myself stalling out. This, realizing how super important this is. What has happened in the world is so many of us stalled out here. When we reach this gap intellectually, you can't go any further. You can't lead. The intellect cannot lead anymore. Okay. And so what the ego suggested is they let the emotions lead. We realize, I can't lead anymore. Let the emotions lead. You see, then get to this yin yang thing in the world. Yang can't do it. Let yin do it. Right? And then the yin does it for a long time. They can't succeed either. Yin can't do it. Let yang do it. And we just go around and around in cycles like that. And this is exactly what's happened in the world, is trying to get it. We try to get intellectually, only goes so far, and we run into this gap problem. And then we stall out. We try to impress everybody about how smart we are, but that doesn't really help people either, you see? And then overall, collectively, everybody kind of says, you know what, this isn't working. Let's give the yin a chance. You know, let's go to the emotional side of things. Maybe that can do it. That's the same problem. It's the exactly same problem. And yet, we don't know what the problem is, so we're helpless. We just let the other, you know, the yin takes over, and we just say, the other didn't work, so this has to work. This must work. We're helpless. We don't understand what does work, actually. So we end up falling into the trap of just applying something else that doesn't work. Same old, same old. This has been going on and on and on and on and on and on for so long. For so long. And it just continues. Blindly. Blindly, we keep going on this way. And just basically, listlessly hoping. Just listlessly hoping. So, this problem is very well known by the great teachers, very well known, and so they've been working with some test pilots to help get this information out. Those who were willing to take this leap of faith and get past the gap and actually practice, and then to recognize, this is what the trouble is. Absolutely, if everyone in the world were to practice this, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. If everyone were to practice this for several months, get up to speed so they can say it pretty much all during the day. They're just, yeah, I am not a body, I am free, in all sorts of circumstances. I am not a body, I am free. You say it silently, mentally. I'm walking down the street. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. If everyone in the world did that for 2 months' time, this would dissolve the problems of the world. We would all know that we're irreversibly free, and we're irreversibly going to be free of all problems that we've ever had. Everyone would know it. Everyone in the world would know it. It's that simple. It is that simple. The trouble is that not everyone in the world is going to do it. They can. There's nothing stopping them whatsoever. But certainly they're not going to do it if nobody else is doing it, right? Because pretty much most people follow the herd. Is everybody else doing it? Okay, I'll do it. Nobody's doing it, only a few. Oh, that's scary. I better not do that. Most people like to wait until it's been alpha tested and beta tested, and it's been tested. Because they're used to technology and how buggy it is, how incredibly buggy it is, and they want to wait until all the bugs are worked out. But in this case, there's no bugs at all. So waiting is a losing game. Waiting is a losing game. It's a futile game. It gets you nowhere. This is effective right now. There are no bugs to it. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. There are no bugs to that at all. Nothing to work out. It's flawless software, spiritual software, flawless. It's the ultimate app. Okay, it is the ultimate app. So all that everyone has to do, just use the ultimate app, and that's it. You will know that you are now irreversibly on the path to success, irreversibly. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, if we can get a groundswell of those doing this, if we could just get some people who do this for 2 months, get up to speed on it, get some fourth phasers up to speed, and start showing others that we've done this, and you can do it too. Start getting a 100th monkey sort of thing going. It is possible that great, great help can come to the world. The more people that do this, the more people start saying, hey, yeah, I don't have to wait. I don't have to wait. I can do this. It could happen. I don't know if it will or not, but it certainly could. And it's worth doing our part to help bring this about. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And we're not directing this any particular place. We're just asserting it. And of course, where else can we direct it to except the mind? The mind is, there's nothing outside of the mind. It's not like we're here and the mind's over there. Just assert it, and the mind is here, is getting it. Just assert it. The mind is, it's impacting the mind for sure. The mind is being reminded, oh, yeah, putting the IV, it's coming out of its coma. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, I'm very happy to be able to work on this with those who want to. This has been my purpose in life. This has been my goal in life. I knew that I had a role to play to help out spiritually somehow, but nobody seemed to understand how. I came in the world and said, I'm here to help out the world spiritually. And all the so-called spiritual people in the world who were stalled out, almost all of them stalled out in some way, just trying to impress others with how spiritual they were. They said, oh, yeah, great, great. Welcome. Here's what you need to do. Let me impress you with my spiritual knowledge and help you out, so I'll, guide you in what needs to be done and stuff. And I said, no. I'm here to help you because you're stalled out. They didn't like that. They didn't like that. Generally, those who are trying to impress others on how spiritual how spiritually advanced they are. They don't like anybody coming to them and saying, hey, I'm here to help you because you're stalled out. They don't like that at all. They say, who are you to tell me that? And this is what I have run into my whole life, is that. They don't. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? You know, who are you to tell me? I'm used to having all these fawning people look up to me saying, wow, you're so wonderfully spiritual. You're so knowledgeable. You've met some Zen master in Kyoto, and you've been to South India, you know, and you stayed in an ashram, and you've worked with, oh, you've met such and such and such and such, and you met the Dalai Lama, and you know, wow. You're amazing. You know, this is incredible. I feel in the presence of spirituality. You know, they're used to this people fawning over them. Okay, and so somebody comes and says, "Hey, just do this practice. Forget about all this blah blah blah. I don't care. Just do this practice." Okay, you're stalled out. You need to get past this gap. Here's how you do it. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a. And they say, "Whoa, whoa, 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 whoa." Let's get something straight here. You know, I'm the big cheese. You know, I'm the one who's impressive. No, they're the ones who are stalled out and I've been focusing on trying to impress others. You know, but I'm not impressed. I'm not impressed. I've never been impressed with the spirituality of this planet. Never been impressed, except for the real teachers. Those are tremendously impressive. But overall, it's not impressive. This world, okay? Spirituality of this planet is not impressive whatsoever, okay? Because very few are actually doing what works. Very few are actually doing what works. But we can increase that number because it's easy. And this is another thing, the intellect, you know, not just the intellect, the yin and the yang both hate this, like the ego, which is both the yin and the yang, is the ego, is like, they don't want it to be easy. What do you mean it's easy? I need a lot of time to get this done, you know. No, what do you mean I can do it right now and it's easy? No way, you know, no way. And so why? They're catering to time still. They've been worshiping time for so long. This idol, this non-existent idol they're imagining. They say, I can't turn my back on this idol. This idol's going to get mad at me. Then they're never going to cure what my problems are. So I can't say it's easy. I got to say, wow, it's really difficult. It's going to take a long time, you know. So they told me, everyone told me, oh, it's going to take you a long time. Yeah, it's going to take you a lot of time to do this. And I said, no. Come, easy, quick. But the resistance was so severe here in this planet. Because they're so idolatrous here of time. That ended up, you know, delaying, stalling like that. But it's here now. It's here now. Better late than never. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, it may seem like, well, I went too slow. Well, I feel that way sometimes. But if you really look at the landscape, spiritual landscape, you know, there's not a lot of this going on, if any. So maybe I was able to get there, you know, way ahead of most, actually, by just this intense effort. So I have to look at it like, you know, yeah, it took me, I'm embarrassed it took me so long. You know, it's like shameful, wow. But given, obviously, the circumstances must be incredibly difficult. The resistance must be so extreme here that we're fortunate that anyone makes it here, actually. We're very fortunate if anybody gets to this point. That's how much resistance and arrogance there is in this world, you know, because there's been so much stalling out throughout the ages that people just think, well, that's it, you know, that's as far as you can go, and now let's just make the most of that, and let's be impressive about it, and so better, you know, better late than never. We'll see how well we can do with it. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. This is the smart way. Okay, if you want to be smart, if you want to be impressive, then do it the smart way, and you really will be impressive. And there's nothing wrong with being genuinely impressive. The genuine article is very impressive. There's nothing wrong with that. It should be that way. Absolutely. So, Yeah, be impressive by being truly successful. Okay, you can't be really impressive if you're not successful, because you'll end up spending your time putting down those who recognize that you're stalled out. You'll spend your time trying to impress and put down and try to be greater and making others less, you know, that way. That doesn't work. So be truly successful and be truly impressive. You know, be super impressive. Be absolutely just wow impressive. This is what we want here. This is absolutely what I want. Everyone to be that way. I want everyone to be, you know, completely successful. And so people just say, wow, whatever you did, I want to do it because it absolutely works. There's no question about it. I'm absolutely convinced. I know it works. You know, like that. That's sort of impressive. You don't have to be impressive, or you don't have to say a word as far as the presence. You don't have to say a word. People absolutely know. Just like that. They say, wow. There's no doubt about it. Okay. But that doesn't mean everybody's going to practice. Doesn't mean everybody's going to practice. It doesn't mean that, you see. They're still caught up in time, worshiping time so much that they still say, well, I better not get time too upset with me, you know. I've met people who've been to one of these great teachers, really great teachers, later on in life. It's been, you know, been 50 years or something since they met a great teacher. And they said, yeah, as soon as I met them, I instantly knew that this was a divine being. There's no question. This was just, you know, it's just obvious. And they say, I've never forgotten it. Deep within me, that's still reverberating. It's reverberated for 50 years. Okay. But they haven't necessarily got down to practice yet. They're still, you know, caught in the ego. So they're not really impressive. You know, they're not really impressive. They testify that the teacher, they met someone who really was impressive, and certainly there's something in them that is working, that is silently working within them, and eventually they'll get down to business. But what's really impressive is getting down to business. That's what's really impressive. What's really impressive is getting down to practice. Nothing else is well, that's you know, very impressive. And then ultimately succeeding with practice is, you know, the ultimate impressiveness. But what is really impressive is getting down to business, is practicing. Don't even bother trying to impress anyone with your spiritual knowledge, okay? Because those who know are not impressed at all by that. Not impressed at all. Just get down to practice, and that is impressive. It really is very impressive when you are able to practice like this. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Practicing like this, and you're able to do this all day. When you eventually get up to speed, taking maybe a couple months, just increase, that is very impressive. And anybody who's not very impressed by that doesn't know what they're talking about, actually. Okay, that's a fact, okay. Maybe there's some who are trying to impress others with their intellect to say, it's nothing, that's not any big, it's a big deal. It's very impressive. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And how do you know it's impressive? Because you will impress yourself. You'll prove it to yourself. And you will know that this is very impressive. When you start to see the whole structure of delusion, and you're able, and then you can practice, and you know you're dissolving it all, that is very, very impressive. Don't let anybody say otherwise. You don't pay any attention. If they say otherwise, don't pay any attention. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Like that. Assert it, because you know it's true. You absolutely know it's true. And doing this, again, is very impressive. And you don't need to say anything to anybody to defend how impressive it is, or try to convince anybody. Anybody saying you got to convince me of it doesn't know what they're talking about. Okay, does not know what they're talking about, which is okay. They're stalled out, and they need to get clued in to how to get past this gap. That's all. And so you will eventually help clue them in. Okay. You will eventually help clue them in. And then they will do it. And then they'll realize, hey, I really am impressive now. Great. Yeah. And nothing wrong with that. You absolutely prove to yourself. When you prove to yourself just how tremendous that you are the one mind, you know, wow, that is great. That is wonderful. That is helpful. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So, what I'm trying to do is trying to get those started into this. You know, say, come on, you can do it. Prove to yourself you can do it. Prove to yourself you can do it, and then you really will be impressive. And keep in mind, again, that if you don't do it, you're not going to impress anybody that really knows anything, really. You're not going to ever. Never. And then you just play ego games. You just play spiritual ego games, and which is not any fun, actually. Having seen it, people carry it all the way through their whole lives, and it's a drag. It's a drag. It's bitter. You know, you don't want to be bitter. It's easy to not be bitter. All you have to do is just start saying this simple little assertion. Assert this simple, I am not a body, okay? It's easy to say that. I am not a body. Just assert it. I am not a body. I am free. I am spirit. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me. This is all we need to say. It's that simple. We have the promise of Jesus on this. He says, just do this, and this is sufficient. This is absolutely potently helpful, and will absolutely bring you to success. That's it. Because that's all we need to be reminded of, that I am not a body, right? I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Right there is the whole enchilada. It's got it all right there. Easy. Simple and easy. So, of course, when you do this, you won't be impressing those who like to be impressed by all sorts of faux spirituality. You know, say, well, what happened? What are you doing? Are you just saying this? Oh, you know, what about this teacher here in the book? You've read any good books lately? And you know, you won't be impressive anymore. That's okay, because you'll be impressing yourself. You'll be impressing yourself. You see, those who need to get convince everybody else when they're stalled out. I need to convince people I've made it. You know, even though deep down they know I'm stuck. So I'm stuck. What do I do? Oh, convince others that I've made it. Okay. Well, those that you're trying to convince, they don't even know what success is. So, you know, and that doesn't work. It doesn't work either. So you still feel your failure. So what you really want is to impress yourself, because nobody is feeling impressed when they're stuck. They feel I'm stuck. That's not impressive. Yes, it's really terrible. And I know I've gone around my whole life saying, wow, I'm really not impressive at all. I mean, I'm stuck. But in my case, I realized I was stuck. I said, I'm not impressive. I said, something's wrong. I came here to be truly impressive by truly succeeding, and I'm not succeeding. There's something wrong. What's wrong? And so I keep working to see what is it, what's the problem here. But when you start truly impressing yourself by doing this practice and realizing, wow, I am finally doing what I came here to do. I'm finally coming here to succeed. I came here to succeed, and now I am finally succeeding. Then you will feel, hey, I am impressive. I am doing this. I'm taking care of business here. Right? TCB, taking care of business. You know, I'm a spiritual Elvis here, you know. I'm getting it done. So, and then, you know, you don't have to feel like I don't have to impress anybody. I don't have to try to, you know, convince anybody. You know, I know I'm doing the right thing. That's all. And you feel more confident. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And yes, I already know that this moment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this moment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. And yes, I already know that this day is already exactly the way that I want it to be. And yes, I already know that this life is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. And this is, you know, and then go back to, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So Jesus used to tell me, when I started out in with a course in miracles, he said, come on, go. Come on, don't stall out. Don't stall out. I mean, this is Jesus' advice, okay? If you want to know in a nutshell what Jesus' advice as far as personally, if you're talking with Jesus, don't stall out. That's it. Don't stall out. Keep the momentum going. Don't stall out. Because this is the problem. Stalling out is the problem. It most definitely is the problem. And then you just end up trying to compensate for feeling like, well, I'm a failure. So how do I compensate for the failure that I feel that I am? And then you get into all sorts of troubles. So don't stall out. Don't stall out. Don't stall out. That's it. And then getting to the point where you say, I just can't fail. I can't stall out. I've got to. And Jesus saying, just do this practice, okay, and you'll succeed. And saying, wow, okay, I mean, I thought I could do it. Figure it out better, but this seems so easy, so simplistic, you know, wow, but okay, let me try, I'm going to try, and then I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, of course, if you have a group of people, let's say you're a spiritual personality and you've got a group of people that are looking up to you. Well, what you got to do? You got to keep them entertained, right? You got to keep them entertained is what happens. And so you've got to spin a whole bunch of stories, right? Drop a whole bunch of spiritual names. And then like they're very entertained. It's like, wow, this is very entertaining. Is he? Whereas this here is not so entertaining. You know, this is getting down to business here. So I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. We keep repeating that over and over, repetition wins. Okay, repetition is the winner. It's the winning ticket. Repetition is a winning ticket. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Now, if this is all you're doing, you know, how can you hold a crowd of people who want to be spiritually impressed? They're going to all go poof, you know. Because there's no, you know, where are the stories? Where are the stories? Absolutely. So, but it doesn't matter. Let them go. You don't have to impress anybody. Just impress yourself. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Exactly as God created me. So impress yourself. And this is how you impress yourself. When you get down to actual practicing, you will impress yourself. Okay. And when you impress yourself, then who cares if somebody else isn't, you know, impressed? You're not telling enough stories for them. You know, that doesn't bother you. It doesn't bother you. Let me bring this down a little bit. So I already feel, you know, that I'm succeeding. So I'm not so needy that I need other people to think that I'm succeeding. I don't have to cater to their, you know, their notions of success, which are, you know, not correct at all. And so I've seen this firsthand, unfortunately, in various situations where spiritual entertainers, you know, they just remain spiritual entertainers their whole life because they just cannot, the idea of losing their audience is too much for them. They can't do it now. Here, and what I've done here is I've built up an audience here, and then I'm showing that, hey, we don't have to be afraid of losing our audience. Whether all the audience disappears or not doesn't matter to me one way or the other. I'd rather they stay, absolutely. That would be great. But I'm not going to refrain from taping this way just because maybe some will say, that's not entertaining enough, you know. So I'm saying to those who in the world who feel, I don't want to lose my audience, I'm saying, you know what? Maybe you'll lose some. Maybe you'll gain some. Who's to say? But do it anyway. Impress yourself. It's time to impress yourself instead of trying to impress others. Time to impress yourself. Okay. Impressing yourself is where it's at in this world. Not trying to impress others. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now you may say, well, that's not very impressive. Yeah. But when you're able to do this all day and keep doing it, you know what? You're going to say, hey, that was very impressive, what I just did. And then you will feel like, hey, I just feel I'm getting it done, actually. I get this feeling like I'm going to succeed. You really feel that way. Say, I got what it takes. And then you've impressed yourself and you just say, wow, I do have what it takes. I don't have to go up on that stage and try to impress the hangers-on, you know, the hangers-on who want to be entertained. I don't have to do that. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. There. See, that's more assertive. So it may take 3 or 4 or 5, whatever. It may take a little while to you can get out something that's really assertive. And then you say, wow, okay, great. Just keep getting to that assertiveness. Keep getting to that assertiveness where you feel like, yeah, I'm feeling a little more assertive now about it. And as you start out, you won't feel so assertive. Okay, that's fine. A little soft jab. That's okay. You're already impressing yourself because you're doing what the ego said you'll never do. You're doing what the ego told you can never do. So that's very impressive. Extraordinarily impressive. Getting down to business is extraordinarily impressive. Especially in this place, this world. Where every excuse to fail is most certainly present here. You got it all, the excuses here to fail. Absolutely you do. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. I left that exactly. I am not a spirit. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. But even if you leave out exactly, it's still the same. Exactly is just an helpful emphasis. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. Jesus uses both ways are okay. I prefer to put in the exactly, for the emphasis. It's helpful to emphasize. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. No changes at all. Exactly as God created me. No changes. Right? There's no external cause at all to change anything about how God created me. I am still flawlessly exactly the way that God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Remember, this experience we think we're having, this is just mind thinking it's a body. Where I am not a body. There are no real bodies at all. This mind believing that it's a body. It's just a figment of mind imagination that's taking place there. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And like I said, I hope this audio is working, but I'm not. I'm holding my breath. I'm not going to hold my breath. Because if not, I don't know what I'm going to do. Really. Now, I did get some feeling like that yesterday, that 3 hours, I was thinking I need to do something that's 3 hours. And then this reminded me something of a meeting I had with Jesus where he talked about three is enough. I was talking about something, you know, and he was saying, no, three is enough. I was thinking, three is enough, just three. Now, maybe he's talking about three people practicing together. That's possible. Maybe practicing people practicing together, three, might be really powerful. But maybe he's talking about, you know, do a concentrated practice for 3 hours. Do a concentrated practice for 3 hours. Now, how difficult is that, actually? I dare say that most people watch 3 hours of television a day. A lot of people do. A lot of people spend 3 hours on their computer fiddling around every day. I dare say, and there's 24 hours in the day, and everybody in the world is spending 3 hours a day doing something. Okay? They're not sleeping 24 hours a day. And they're not working 24 hours a day. So, we certainly can do 3 hours a day. You might do it like between 8 and 11 at night, or 7 and 10. You know, after dinner, do 3 hours. Again, this is a goal to get to. So I'm trying to test pilot this and show it's possible. Now, I can do 2 hours easy. I can do 2 hours easy. I've been doing 2 hours now continuously. And that is easy for me, not a problem. Three, you know, I need to get up to speed here. But if we can do 3 hours, ultimately do 3 hours, Jesus says, that's enough. That's all it takes. That's all it takes. You're going to, you know, that this is optimal. Okay, this is optimizing. And you're hitting on all cylinders, is what he said. You're hitting on all cylinders. Just that amount is you're going very rapidly. Okay, you don't need to do five. You don't need to do six. You know, you don't need to do 10 hours a day. Just three. I'm saying ultimately. Okay, obviously when you start out, you'll just be happy if you do. You know, just you can remember a little. You know, do a little bit, little bit, little bit, little bit, little bit. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, we know as all this spiritual lore and history of all these different practices and everything complex is this, and we think, wow, okay, this one's nice. Now, let me see if I can find some other ones. And, you know, you can spend your whole lifetime doing that and you never practice. This is called spiritual dilettantism. Don't be a dilettante. Nobody who knows is impressed by that. Yeah, I can say this mantra. I have 20 different mantras in 20 different languages, and I can do this, and I can do this, and I can do this. That's foolishness. The ones who have succeeded historically are always the ones who go to their teacher, their guru, whatever, and they are told, just do this. This is what's going to work for you. This is what's going to work for you. And then they just do it. They drop everything else and just do that, and poof, like a miracle, it works. Those are the ones that succeed. Those are the ones that succeed. So being smart as we are and wanting to be successful as we want to, we say, hey, yeah. Let's be smart and successful. Let's do what actually works. Let's use the winning formula instead of the losing formula. Because if you look at the ones who just go wandering around like dilettantes, you know, amateur dilettantes, oh, I got, yeah, this one and this one, and maybe I do this and maybe I do that. Yeah. They don't succeed. You don't have a lot of success that way. That's not a formula for success at all. So, it's sticking with one potent assertion is what works, historically. Sticking with one potent assertion is what works. And getting a recommendation from a great teacher saying, do this, this is what will work for you. You're super blessed. You're super fortunate when that occurs. And for me, I've been able to get this. And it wasn't just for me. Jesus is saying to us in general in this world at this time, this is what will work for you. Say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. It's getting very windy here. Maybe winter is returning. Take a little adjustment break. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So all we're doing is we're succeeding. What's that? I don't know. All we're doing is succeeding. That's it. All we're doing is succeeding. That's all. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me. So what we're doing here is encouraging you to impress yourself. That's it. The more you impress yourself, the better your practice will be. And hopefully, since everybody stalls out. And everybody needs then to take this leap of faith. So everybody, you know, stalls out. And so we just have to say, okay, that's what happens, and now I can get past that by practicing. That's it. So basically everybody stalls out and they feel like they're failure. They're not really impressive. They're really... How impressive is failure? They feel I failed. Wow, I failed, or I'm a failure. So everybody, I'm gonna take some of the. Everybody feels at some point they're a failure on this. They reach a point and they say, wow, I've done so much work, but I'm still a failure. So that's normal. That's what happens. And then, so you do need then to impress yourself. And the only way to impress yourself is to actually do what actually works, what actually gets you past this gap problem, which I've spoken of extensively and can speak of again. Okay. And it's never anything that you can see that you can't solve it analytically, intellectually, emotionally, yin-yangly. You cannot. It's not a yin-yangly solvable situation at all. It's only a practice solution. Only practicing will solve this, meaning only having the right medicine for our mental sickness, which is the right assertion. Okay, now there can be many forms of right assertion. We're not claiming that this is some exclusive form that works better than any other form, and there are no other forms. Of course, now it depends on culture, your place and time, your place, and it depends on a lot of different aspects. But essentially, they're saying the same thing. It's just I am what I am, you know. I am. That's the, you know. Essentially, it's the same thing. And so we're not going to fiddle around with this. We're just going to say, I am not a body. So first we say what we're not. I am not a body. Because this is what we've been believing for so long. I am not a body. I am free. See, I'm not bound at all. I am free. I am still spirit. Okay, exactly as God created me. And this is what Jesus Christ recommends for us right here, right now, in this situation, in the world where we're at with our beliefs, with the world the way it is, etc., etc., etc. So I'm not going to second guess that at all. That would be foolish to second guess it. If Jesus Christ says this works, this is the most effective, this is what will do it for you, then I'm going to do it, plain and simple. I'm not going to try to get cute about it and get tricky and, you know, back 1500 years ago, someone else said you can try to say this, and you know, and I wonder which one is better, and let me compare the, you know, what's that? That's, you're outsmarting yourself. Outsmarting yourself. Jesus would not have given this out right here, right now, unless he's saying that right here, right now, given the way your belief systems are, and et cetera, the way the world is, this is going to work for you. So just do it. Just do it. It's that simple. And those, they say, those who have faith in their guru, their teacher, those are the ones who succeed. Those are the ones who succeed. Sri Sagadatta Maharaj said, I had just, for some reason, I just absolutely trusted my teacher. There's no doubt in my mind. When he said, do this and it will work for you, he said, I had no doubts at all. And so all I did was I just did it. And boom, very rapidly, was awakened from this delusion of being a body, you know, not being free and all this nonsense. Because he trusted. He said, I just, for some reason, I trusted my teacher. He said, I don't know why. But he said, that's the greatest blessing of all. Trusting your teacher is the greatest blessing of all. Because they know what's going to work. So, we deserve just as good as that. And so we deserve to trust our teacher, so to speak. And there's no greater teacher. There's no one who's clearer about the mind than Jesus Christ. There are others who are also totally clear about the mind. But there, you can't say there's someone's even more clear than being perfectly clear, right? If you're perfectly clear, there's no way anything higher or low. You know, you can't get higher than that. So if someone who's as high as you can get tells you, just do this and it's going to work for you, then we'd be fools not to do it. We'd be really foolish not to do it. And that's what I finally realized, like, wow, you know, I don't want to die a fool. I don't want to die a fool. And if this is saying, do this, I said, wow, I better do this. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, it is true that this is an assertion. Okay. Now, there are some people, I'm sure, in the world who want to go about a different way. That's fine. Okay. But for those who want to make assertions, affirmations, assertions, okay. Those who feel, you know what? I feel like I can do this. I can succeed this way. Then this is the way. Then just do it. And don't worry about those who might have some other way to reassure themselves somehow. You know, there are various approaches, okay. But if your approach is, you know what, I like to assert, I can assert. I feel like I'm sort of more mental, and that I'm able to really assert ideas and concepts, and you know, then this is your way to really assert. Say, I know what is true. I know this, and this is what is true. I know it is true. I know what is true. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Do this assertion. Assert it, assert it, assert it, assert it, and gradually you'll feel more and more assertive, and saying, wow, and just start to wake up and recover. It's like, wow, I'm feeling like I'm coming out of like a haze, you know, a haze of stupefaction. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So some are drawn towards using their mind in this way, and they have to succeed this way. So let us succeed in this way. It's that simple. Let us succeed in that way. Some, you know, have a different way where they, but that's okay. That's okay. We don't let, they will let them succeed in their way. We're going to succeed in this way, which is a lot of people can succeed in this way. A lot of people are this way. A lot of people tend to, you know, be sort of mentally focused, okay? A lot of people, a lot of us. And so this is the way. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So, you know, there are other various ways, and you think, oh, they're drawing pretty mandalas, and they're doing all this various stuff. Oh, it's so romantic, spiritual romantic, whatever. You know, there's nothing more impressive than somebody who's taking care of their business and impressing themselves. And by doing this, we are taking care of business, and we're impressing ourselves. We're impressing ourselves. You know, doing this all day like this, I said, hey, you know, you get those people in you know, other times that are doing japa mantra all day, they just do it all day, never stopping, you know, and you think, wow, you know, that's very impressive. Well, when you find that you can do it all day, and you can keep doing it, and you say, hey, yeah, I can do it all this, and I know that this saying this is super effective. Jesus, I take Jesus' promise as true. This is, so I'm doing what is super effective all day. Just imagine just how incredibly, how quickly, you know, success is coming. How quickly success is coming when this is the case. So you don't feel like some failure, you know, at this point. You say, no, I'm succeeding. I'm not a body. I am free. I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. And we don't need to expand upon this. We just keep saying it. Just keep saying it. Just keep saying it. It evaporates, you know, it evaporates the continuity fear that we have. It evaporates. The mind is, you know, free. What do I do without time? Oh my God, how do I get cured? Oh, I'm not a body. I'm free. I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. Oh, okay. Yeah, maybe it's all okay. Maybe it's okay. Keep reassuring the mind. Keep reassuring the mind. Keep reassuring the mind. The more we reassure the mind, the more we can recognize that time has never existed. And we've never been trapped. Never been trapped. We've just been pretending to be trapped. The more we practice, the more we realize this. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, we can go back in various epochs, even in my own life. There have been many, many phases, spiritual phases in the world, actually, quite a few, where people really got after it for a while, and there was a spiritual upheaval. There haven't really been any recently. You know, technology has put a damper on it big time. We're all stupidly distracted, but it is possible spiritual upheavals to take place. It is possible for people to start getting together and practicing this, you know, in an intense way, like for 3 hours. It is possible. And when people start doing that, they start saying, hey, I'm getting it. And when you start radiating this attitude, I'm getting it. People, others start noticing, say, wow, what are you getting? What are you getting? What are you getting? You know, I want to get it too. What are you getting? What are you getting? And upheaval start happening. And you start, people start to realize, I don't want to miss out on this. Everyone wants to be successful, spiritually successful, actually. And when they start realizing, hey, there is a way I can be spiritually successful, you know, then spiritual upheavals take place. And we are certainly in the need of one. We are in such a stalled out condition in this world. We are in such a severely stalled out condition. I mean, it's like the 1950s all over again or something. The corporations just locked the world down right now, which in the 50s is what happened too. And then the 60s happened. And then other stuff happened where people got even more serious. The 60s kind of loosened things up, and people started saying, maybe we don't have to do what corporations tell us to do. We have to do. And then various practices, and people started getting after it. And the corporations, you know, have fought back now. And I'm talking about just globally, this overall corporate global mindset, you know, that is just incorporated the whole world, which extends beyond the boundaries of this planet, actually, very much so. Just as, for instance, the East India Company in India in the past extended beyond the boundaries of India all the way back to, you know, to England and around the world. I mean, they're mostly in India, and they would expand into China and various places. But in other words, they're a corporation, but behind the corporation is an empire. Okay, behind the corporation is an empire. And so behind the corporations of this planet is an empire, and the empire stretches beyond the boundaries of this planet, for sure. So we're under heavy incorporation in this world right now, and we're being told what to do by corporations, and corporations are not telling us what really works, how to really succeed. That's the spiritual teachers who tell us what really succeeds. The corporations will not tell you what will really succeed for you. They will not tell you. They will do everything in their power to distract you away from that, which they certainly are doing. Which they certainly are doing. They want you to do what they want you to do, period. They know their business, and they want to succeed at their business, and you are part of their success at their business by them getting you to do what they want you to do. Okay, and that is to believe that you are a body. Okay, that's what they want. They want you to believe you are a body. Okay, that doesn't succeed. They want you to believe in time. That doesn't succeed. You will feel like you're a failure, and then you'll feel that a greater need for their product, because you feel like you're a failure, and then they'll advertise this product, and they say, if you get this product, you'll feel like you're a success. And so you go and buy. This basic advertising. Corporations want you to feel like you're a failure, so that then you will work really hard and buy their products, which they tell you will make you feel like a success. And this is just a dead end, closed circuit type of thing. It just goes around and around like this. Get you nowhere. Get you absolutely nowhere. So we do need a spiritual revival. We do need a spiritual upheaval. And the way to do it is for people start spending 3-hour blocks of time together saying, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And let's brighten this up. I am not a body. That's too bright. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. You see, we have to raise the roof. We got to raise the roof at this time. It's time to raise the roof. Because if we don't, we're going to get trapped into this endless, you know, failure loop of thinking that we don't realize how the mindset we've been conditioned with makes us feel like such failures. If we believe we're a body, we believe in time, process, space, we will feel like we're extreme failures, spiritual failures. And then we will easily be induced into buying things to try and get rid of that feeling. And this is what corporations have figured out, of course, that, hey, you know, if we can sucker people into this, we can just keep our profits, you know, keep our profits up indefinitely this way. And we can, you know, live a real super lifestyle here, paying everybody else to take out our trash. And meanwhile, everybody else is trapped in this cycle of doesn't work. So at some point, you have to get free of that. Have to get free of it. You have to actually realize success is within you. You have the tools now. We just say this: I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. And that's the only tool you need. You don't need to buy anything the corporations are trying to sell you, actually. The necessities of life, you know, but whatever. But you don't even need to pay any attention to their advertising. You don't need to pay any attention to their programming. All their programming on movies, television, pop culture, everything, news, whatever, is all designed to sell you success. Sell you what they tell you will make you feel successful. It's all designed around that. Okay. You don't need that at all. You don't need to pay attention. You already know how to be successful. You just say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. That's all you need to say. Just say that. That's all you need to say. You don't need to buy anything. You don't need to buy anything. It's free. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. You can use that all day long. It doesn't cost you a penny. It doesn't cost you a penny. Now, in the world, we need to buy food, and, you know, most of us need a car insurance. Okay, of course, that's pragmatic. But doing this practice doesn't cost you anything. Doesn't cost you anything. So wherever you are, you can say, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, in a dream last night, I had this dream, and it was just, wow, this dream was just encapsulated my life and what's going on, and it was very intense. And I came across somebody in the dream after I'd gone through all these difficulties and trials, and I saw somebody in this red toolbox, and they were in this red toolbox, and they were destitute, and they were homeless, and they looked terrible, and their teeth were tearing, and their hair, and they were just rotting, and it was just, you know, destitute man. It was so terrible. And I said, what can I do for you? I said, wow, this is awful. Well, you know, I don't want you to be this way. A moment. So I don't want you to be this way. And I was thinking, what can I do? What can I do? I don't know how to help them. And then I realized that this was myself in the future. This is myself. I was looking at myself in the future if I continued on in this corporate toolbox, this red corporate, this communist, socialist, globalist, one world, in cosmic corporate culture, incorporating this planet into this quote-unquote, you know, we say communist, I mean everyone's indoctrinated, okay? We're all indoctrinated into this box. And I was in this red box, you know. I said, oh my God, if I go along with the world, this is how I'm going to end up, actually. This is how I'm going to end up. I said, I don't want that. And so I asked the Holy Spirit, what do I do? I'm seeing myself in the future. How can I change that? And the Holy Spirit says, practice. Practice. I said, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And so I began practicing very strongly, because this dream I had showed me how I got led into physicality, believing in physicality. And I, in part of the dream, I reached this area where I realized that physicality was trying to lead me into this like ghetto of physicality, where and kill me. There's no question about it. And I said, wow, they're going to, you know, they're trying to get me in a place where there's no friends, and I'm isolated out there, and then kill me. And this did happen in my life, absolutely. And then I said, no. And I skirted around. I got back into an area on the right side of this dream, sort of on the right side I was. And there were other people like me, and I was around people, and I felt safer. And that's where then I came across this person in this red box, toolbox. And, wow. So in other words, if I just stopped there, that's how I'm going to turn out. I saw what happened if I stop there. If I don't practice this, this is how I'm going to end up. I'm going to end up destitute and homeless, which is very true. My situation right now is very much headed that way. I got no safety net. I have no safety net right now. I'm on the thinnest of ice imaginable. It could happen like that, just like my camera stopped functioning. It can happen just like that. Okay. And I said, oh, wow. And that's when I started practicing. I said, wow, I cannot let this happen. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And I realized in that dream, the whole lie is the physicality of it, the belief that we're a body. This is the lie. This is what is entrapping us. We must assert that I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit. Exactly as God created me. This is the only cure there is. It is the only cure there is. This is truth. We must assert the truth. We do not stop and stall out because it's not going to be a good situation. Do not stop and stall out. Okay. So I'm you know, really encouraging people to start saying this. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Do not stall out. What's the advice that Jesus gave me long ago? Back in the I would say probably like in 1980s, the 80s. I met Jesus many times when my body was asleep. I was working with the Course in Miracles so intensely. I met Jesus many times, and he would basically tell me, don't stall out. Go. Forget about everything else. Don't worry about this other stuff. Go. Don't stall out. I said, yeah, well, this teacher here, and it looks like maybe they're stalled out. I said, listen, no. Go. Don't stall out. Don't worry if someone else is stalling out. Just you don't stall out, okay? If someone else is stalling out, they have to deal with that, okay? That's but you just stay on track as fast as possible. So the advice is don't stall out. That's it. Don't stall out. How do you not stall out? Once you get to that point where you feel, wow, I'm just spinning my wheels. I'm so smart, spiritually smart, but I'm spinning my wheels. That's stall out. So say, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me, and just keep saying it. And very soon, you will realize you're past the gap. Along with the as-if exercises are also very helpful, but again, super potent. Don't do those all day. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. Of course, yes, I already know. That I've already crossed the gap. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that this very moment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that I'm already enlightened. You see, so those are the wind sprints that we do. The wind sprints. One moment, please. One moment.
Okay, thank you.
Interruption. What I do? No pause button. I just want you to know. No pause button. Is he's like, oh. Well, God got us through that one. Yes, I already know that that interruption is already exactly the way I really want it to be. See, this I already know that all interruptions are already exactly the way I really want them to be. You see? I already know that this moment, yes, I already know that this moment is exactly the way, already exactly the way I really want it to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. See? So whatever happens, oh, terrible stuff. Oh, this. Oh, I feel so sick. I'm so, oh, okay. But I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And through the last couple months, all sorts of stuff have come up for me, you know, all sorts of really stuff that knock you out. And I just say, oh, okay. And in my mind, I'm just saying, okay, I'm not a body. I am free. I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And I just keep saying this. Just keep saying this. And yes, I already know that this situation is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this situation is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. I already know the situation is already exactly the way I want it to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And you just keep on doing this. That's all. And you get better and better and better at it. Every time something tries to knock you out, and instead you knock it out, you say, hey, you know, they can't bully me anymore, right? I used to be bullied by that, but now I just brushed it off. I just brushed it aside. Can't bully me anymore. And then you start feeling like, hey, I'm succeeding. This is impressive. So, you know, for wherever you go, like church, I've been going to church, and during church, you know, I'm just saying, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And, you know, as we sang the prayers in church, you know, and stuff, and I keep saying, I'm not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. During all of the church service, which is fine, okay, let them, you know, they're trying to negotiate with time here, you know, and partially, you know, trying to figure out some way, how do we let them do whatever they do, it's okay. See, I know the situation is, I already know the situation is already exactly the way I really want it to be. It's not outside of me, is it? So just say, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So you can still go to church, you can still do anything, that's perfectly fine. Enjoy, whatever. But within you, just keep saying, I'm not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Keep saying it. Just keep saying it. Don't just keep on. And if you stop, just pick it up again. That's easy. Just pick it up again. Don't. And the tough part is time will say, wait a minute. You need to fit in with the flow of time here. So you think, it's like merging on a freeway. Like it's all these cars. And you say, how do I get in? No. Don't play that game. See, no. You just assert it. You just brush aside and say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I'm the doctor here. You know, you're not going to tell me how to merge or when to merge. You know, I'm asserting. I'm not merging. I'm asserting. Okay? You're not merging. You're asserting. You're not merging with time. We're not merging things. We're asserting the truth. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So you'll get knocked off your stride over and over and over and over again. And that's fun. It's like, wow, this is interesting. This is quite a nice contest going on here. And you get better and better and better at it, actually. You get better and better and better. But sure, you'll experience getting, you know, someone distracting you, for sure. And you'll forget and you'll say, oh, I can't start again because I need to wait until this situation is finished. And then, of course, that situation morphs into another one, and that morphs into another one. And you're still waiting. You're the doctor. You're not waiting. You're the doctor. You're giving the medicine right now. Hell, there's insanity. Am I practicing? Oh my gosh, insanity. Here, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, we're running up a good session here. And the question is, well, should you have breaks? No, I don't think we should have breaks. No, absolutely not. It's way more important. You'll impress yourself way more if you gut it out and you keep working, give it everything you've got. You can take a break when you're done. Okay, take a break when you're done. Stick with it. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So for me, I know if I stall out, I'm going to be destitute, and I saw what my future is going to be like, and it's horrible. So that's a good motivator right there. You know, you talk about a kick in the seat of the pants. That's the one, right? That'll get your attention. That's an attention getter. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, let's say you run across a truly enlightened teacher. What are you going to ask the teacher? Say, hey, teacher, hey, help me practice. Can you help me practice right now? This moment. Forget about niceties, blah, blah, shop talk. Forget about shop talk. Get me can you help me practice? Can you help motivate me to practice? That's it. If I saw Jesus, I say, Jesus, help me practice right now. Because I've seen my future without practicing. I've seen my future stalling out. I said, help me not stall out, Jesus. Come on, right now, let's do it. I'm not a body. I am free. I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. I say, that's it. Because I know if I do that, I'll succeed. If I don't, I'll stall out. And I know what stalling out is going to bring to me. So just bring me help me practice, help me practice, help me practice. That's it. No shop talk. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am still spirit. Nothing has happened to me at all. You see, everything is fine. I'm still perfect. I've never been touched by any externalness. Never been touched by any externalness. There isn't any externalness. I'm untouched. I'm still perfectly untouched. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And I already know that I've already been irreversibly unfair to the ego. Yes, I already know that I've already been irreversibly unfair to time. Yes, I already know that I've already been irreversibly unfair to the ego. Yes, I already know I've already been irreversibly unfair to time. But I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Yes, I already know that this moment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know this day is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this life is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that I'm already enlightened. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that everything is already perfect. Yes, I already know that all that is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So I'm holding up fine here. I guess I've done enough preparation where I'm able to do this without feeling too much strain. And somebody has to do it. Somebody has to do that. And you know, help out others that where they feel the strain, like, wow, you know, this is a little rough, a little difficult. Come on, keep going. It's not bad. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Do not stall out. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Yes, I already know that I have already totally succeeded. Yes, I already know I've already reached the promised land. Yes, I already know that I'm already free of delusion. Yes, I already know that I'm already awakened. Yes, I already know that I'm already enlightened. Yes, I already know that I'm already blissful. Yes, I already know that everything is already one. Yes, I already know that all appearances have already changed. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as oneness. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as inclusiveness, all inclusiveness. Yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Yes. This, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, we have a lot of knots to undo, you see. So certainly we have to work at it. Just saying it once isn't going to work. I mean, if you said it once with absolute assertion, it would work. With absolute assertion. But because of our continuity fear, we don't have absolute assertion. See, this is the catch-22. So we do have to practice it. We do have to say over and over and over and over. We have to work at it because we do not have this 100% pure assertion due to the fact of our continuity fear. We think, wow, what would happen if I had pure assertion? Oh my gosh, that would change everything. We say, I'm not quite ready for 100% pure assertion. So let me ease up to it. You know, let me ease up to it. And let me just ease up to it and say, hey, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And yes, I already know that I am already absolutely free. Yes, I already know that I am already absolutely free. Yes, I already know that I am still spirit as God created me. Yes, I already know that I am already spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Don't stall out. Don't stall out. Don't stall out. We can't afford to stall out. Okay, the consequences are not nice going forward in this world. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Thank you, everyone, for spending this time together. I call it walking together in the wow, because wow, we're impressing ourselves, you know, is like, wow, this is impressive. We are impressing ourselves as we should, because it is impressive to do this practice. And I think that's about it. Let's see if it goes over 3. Is it going to say, this is it, you have gone as far as you can go? Well, it's still going. What did they do? Increase their maximum time? This is pretty cool. Usually it hits the three hour mark. I mean hour. 3 hour mark. And it says, you've run out. That's it. Video over. This time it didn't do that. So maybe they've upgraded their software and it lets you keep taping. That's pretty cool. Maybe we'll do 4 hours next time. Maybe not. Maybe at some point. But anyway, we sort of geared myself for 3. And we got here. And it's kind of getting cold outside. It's actually not a perfect California day anymore. What's the world coming to? Must be the apocalypse. So, with that said, we say, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And let me see, how can I stop this? Stop recording. All right, many blessings to everyone. Just practice, practice, practice. Do not stall out. Keep building up. Say, I don't want to stall out. Let me keep trying. I don't want to stall out. Every day, just keep trying. I do these videos to help out. Keep encouraging you. Keep trying. Keep trying. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And that's it for this video.